Hello, I'm Tom Hathaway. I'm wearing my BA hat to symbolize that many people in an organization do business analysis, whether they have the job titled business analyst or not. In this e-course, we're going to talk about data flow diagramming. We'll present the who, the what, the when, the where, the why, and the how of creating pictures of business processes or workflows. If you're ever responsible for analyzing workflows to identify disconnects or discrepancies, this technique will help you tremendously. It's a fairly simple idea. It gives you a lot of information on how to look at business processes in a different way. It's actually a tool for visualizing workflow. This technique will help you when you are the one wearing the BA hat. Thank you and enjoy this e-course. In today's wired world, software applications often take center stage in optimizing workflow and increasing productivity. Unfortunately, the process of delivering the right software to the right people at the right time is challenging to say the least. Data flow diagramming is one of the techniques used in the field of business analysis for information technology. Business analysis is sometimes done by business analysts. However, many people in an organization do business analysis, although it's not in their job description. Whether you are the CEO, COO, director, manager, or on the front lines, you may be involved in defining how technology can benefit you and your organization. When you are in that awesome role, you are at that time the one wearing the BA hat. We refer to this role many times throughout all of our courses. This course explains what a data flow diagram, or DFD, is, why you need one, how to create it, and how to use it to minimize the risk of project failure. Using a business scenario, the course demonstrates how to get started with a rigorous physical process model, or RPPM, converting the RPPM to a context DFD, and then exploding the context DFD to a detailed data flow diagram. You'll learn the benefits of process visualization for the business community, for the one wearing the BA hat, for those tasked with developing the solution, and ultimately, for the entire organization. You'll also discover how powerful DFDs are as tools for recognizing and eliminating two of the major problems that haunt IT projects, namely scope creep and project overruns caused by late project change requests. In detail, this course explains and demonstrates the answers to these questions. What is the data flow diagram, and what does it do for you? What's the difference between a rigorous physical process model and a context-level DFD? What symbols can I use on each type of diagram? What is the business value of exploding or leveling a DFD? What's a simple approach for drilling down into a process? How can I show the internal processes and flows that produce the results? What does balancing a data flow diagram mean? And what is the business value? What is the most efficient approach to balancing a DFD? How can I express detailed specifications for processes and data? What business value do detailed process specifications offer? What is metadata, and why do I need it? What does a fully balanced DFD look like? What value does a DFD fragment provide? And ultimately, why should I draw a data flow diagram?
My wife Angela and I have authored numerous courses and delivered them to students around the world. Based on our personal experience, we feel very strongly that these techniques that we use in our business analysis endeavors should be available to anyone, anytime, anywhere on the planet. Because of that, we have made it our personal mission to spread the word of good business analysis techniques in all of our courses, our videos, our ebooks, and our blogs. We hope these techniques will help you whenever you are wearing the BA hat.